Hi, I'm Romina Percy, and welcome back to Earth from Space. Today, the Copernicus Sentinel-1 mission takes us over the cracks in the Brunt ice shelf. The Brunt ice shelf lies in the Weddell Sea sector of Antarctica. As we can see in the image, two very large cracks are visible. The large chasm, running northwards, is called Chasm 1, while the split extending eastwards is referred to as the Halloween crack. First spotted on the 31st of October 2016, the Halloween crack runs from an area known as McDonald Ice Rumples, which is where the underside of the floating ice sheet is grounded on the shallow seabed. This pinning point slows the flow of ice and crumples the ice surface into waves. Chasm 1, on the other hand, has been in place for over 25 years. It was previously stable for many years, but in 2012, it was noticed that the dormant crack started extending northwards. Now, Chasm 1 and Halloween crack are only separated by a few kilometers. When they meet, an iceberg about the size of Greater London will break off. The two lengthening fractures have been set to intersect for years. It's only a matter of time for the two to meet. Using radar images from the Copernicus Sentinel-1 mission, the animation shows the evolution of the two ice fractures from September 2016 until mid-October 2019. The Brunt ice shelf has been monitored by glaciologists for decades and is constantly changing. Early maps from the 1970s indicate that the ice shelf used to be a mass of small icebergs welded together by sea ice. Ice shelf movement is very unpredictable. Routine monitoring from satellites offer unprecedented views of events happening in remote regions and show how ice shelves are responding to changes in ice dynamics, air, and ocean temperatures. As an advanced radar mission, the Copernicus Sentinel-1 can image the surface of Earth through cloud and rain, regardless of whether it is day or night. This makes it an ideal mission for monitoring the polar regions, which are in darkness during the winter months, and for monitoring tropical forests, which are typically shrouded by cloud. And that brings us to the end of this edition. I'm Romina Percy from ESA Web TV Studios, and thank you for watching.